Both mini sheepadoodles and cockapoo originated from the United States. Mini sheepadoodles may grow 14 centimeters or 6 inches higher than cockapoo. Mini sheepadoodles may weigh 9 kilograms or 20 pounds more than cockapoo. Both mini sheepadoodles and cockapoo have the same lifespan. Both mini sheepadoodles and cockapoo have the same litter size, and they also both require moderate maintenance. Peekaboo is a delightful designer pup that's suitable for a wide range of households. Loyal and affectionate, this breed is attached to his family, so much so that he may be quite protective of you in certain circumstances. Naturally, due to their petite size, they don't make good guard dogs, but their tendency to act like one will amuse you to no end. History. The Peekaboo is one of the oldest of the hybrid, or designer breeds. He was developed in the 1950s with a cross of a Pekingese with a miniature or toy poodle. The goal was to produce a non-too-low-shedding dog suitable for people with allergies. The Peekaboo gained popularity by the early 1960s, around the same time as the Cockapoo. Despite the popularity of the Peekaboo, there is no breed club. The hybrid has remained largely the first-generation cross. The parents are usually Pekingese and poodles. There is no indication that multi-generational breeding will occur, but never say never. Due to his small, lap-friendly size and friendly, affectionate temperament, the Peekaboo has maintained a strong following. Appearance. The Peekaboo is a small dog that can grow up to 11 inches in height. They can weigh anywhere between 8 and 20 pounds, but any dog less than 8 pounds at an adult weight is considered a miniature Peekaboo. Peekaboos have medium to long and are very wavy single coat. As we've mentioned above, their coat is hypoallergenic and perfect for those with allergies. This also means that you won't be finding dog hair all over your house. Their coat is very soft too, perfect to cuddle up next to. It is very common for Peekaboo owners to clip their dog's coat. The longer the coat is, the more hassle it is to take care and more bushing is required. We will go into more details about grooming your Peekaboo later on. Color. Your Peekaboo can come in a range of different colors. Remember, there is no breed standard, so anything is possible. These colors can include silver, gray, white, red, cream, apricot, chocolate, and black. However, while their coat can be solid in color, they can also have a range of different markings across the body. Personality. The Peekaboo is a loving and loyal dog who is dedicated to his family. An ideal lap dog, he delights in being part of every family activity. He is gentle and rarely combative. He is an intelligent dog who is happiest with his owner, especially out in the great outdoors. Protective of his family, he'll defend them with everything in that small body. Because he's naturally suspicious of strangers and new dogs, early and ongoing socialization is a must for the Peekaboo. If not properly socialized, he can be slightly aggressive or timid. That's true of any dog, but particularly so far those who tend toward being wary of strangers. Enrolling your young Peekaboo in a puppy kindergarten class is a great start down the road of socialization. Inviting visitors over regularly, taking him to busy parks and stores that allow dogs, and going on strolls to meet the neighbors will also help him polish his social skills. Training. Peekaboo puppies are adorable furballs with a tendency towards separation anxiety and domineering behavior towards very young children or other dogs. Like other small dogs, Peekaboos sometimes bark quite a bit to assert their personalities. They're quite loyal dogs and thus suspicious of strangers at first. With positive reinforcement, training, and early socialization, however, they mature into well-behaved adults. Great training helps create an extra sense of security for the Peekaboo as well. Health problems. The Peekapoo can inherit health issues prevalent with its parent breeds. Some common issues include progressive retinal atrophy, Legkov-Perthes disease, patellar luxation, and hip dysplasia. They can also suffer from respiratory problems due to their flatter face, so you should keep your Peekapoo in an air-conditioned home during the summer. History of the Sheepadoodle. Sheepadoodles are a doodle designer breed that is a cross of a poodle and an Old English sheepdog. Contrary to many other designer breeds, Sheepadoodles have been around for some time already. The first accounts of them are from the 1960s when the U.S. Army bred standard poodles to English sheepdogs as an experiment for developing a new breed. The term doodle and their use as family dogs became popular in the 1990s. Since then, Sheepadoodles have made many dog owners fall in love with the loving nature and loyal character of the breed. Appearance. The mini Sheepadoodle, a mix between the mini poodle and sheepdog, stands at between 48 and 52 centimeters and weighs between 11 to 20 kilograms. He is solidly built with a broad skull and face. The coat is usually medium length and can be either straight, wavy, or curly. The coat can be quite a few colors depending on the parent. Some are brown, cream, or black, while others are white and gray or white and brown. As with most poodle mixes, affectionately termed doodles, the coat of a Sheepadoodle can tend more straight and more curly, and it's generally hard to tell until the puppy gets a little older. Sheepadoodles are often compared to Bernie Doodles, which are a mix between a poodle and a Bernese mountain dog. Bernie Doodles have a similar giant teddy bear vibe, big fluffy paws, shaggy faces, and furry, floppy ears. However, Bernie Doodles come in a greater variety of colors and share more of the Bernese Mountain Dog's personality traits. They tend to be more energetic and protective. Temperament. The Sheepadoodle is a loyal and committed companion to its owners. He loves to be around his people and spend time with them. Sheepadoodles are great with children and often become a best friend to a family's little ones. Because OES were bred to be in part guard dogs, Sheepadoodles can be aloof with strangers if they're not properly socialized as young dogs. They have a loud bark and will let you know if someone approaches your house and property. If you live in an apartment, the Sheepadoodle's watchfulness might not be a good fit for you. While Sheepadoodles enjoy being active with their owners, they usually settle down quite a bit after their puppy stage. Other breeds of doodles can be high-strung for most of their life. After the Sheepadoodle reaches adulthood, he will appreciate calm afternoons on the couch with you. That does not mean that your Sheepadoodle doesn't enjoy learning. In fact, they're highly intelligent dogs that will love to train with you if you want to teach tricks or even try out dog sports such as agility or nose work. Training. In general, training a Sheepadoodle should be pretty simple. This breed is highly intelligent and obedient. They also aim to please their owners, so they should be able to learn and respond to commands relatively quickly. It is important, however, to begin the training process from an early age. This will help your pet learn commands from an early age. They'll also be smaller when they're still puppies and easier to control. In addition to training your Sheepadoodle, socializing them from an early age is also important. Introduce your Sheepadoodle to other dogs and people. Bring them with you to a variety of places. This will help your dog learn how to interact with different people and animals, as well as how to interact with different situations. You may want to wait until your dog is fully vaccinated to introduce them to other dogs or bring them to many places with you. Health issues. Before bringing home a Sheepadoodle, take a few minutes to learn about some of the potential health problems this breed may face. Every sheepdog poo will not develop all or even any of these problems, but knowing what to look for can help you decide if you need to seek medical attention for your pup. Hip dysplasia is one potential problem to look out for. Hip dysplasia occurs when the hip bone doesn't form properly and the thigh bone and hip bone rub together, This problem is more prevalent in large breed dogs, like the Sheepadoodle, and may require surgery. Since cataracts are a big problem for poodles, a Sheepadoodle may also develop them. Cataracts can impact a dog's vision and may cause them to start bumping into things as they walk. Your veterinarian would be able to treat cataracts with surgery. If you're considering any of these breeds, don't forget to check your local shelter and consider rescuing your new furry family member. Check out this playlist for more details on popular pet breeds. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notices so you don't miss more videos about our preferred animal pooches and far more. See you in the next video.